Students, today we are going to learn next point, that is the sum of the terms of a GP. Okay, so if we have GP is A, AR, AR square and so on, and last term is AR raised to n minus 1, that is the nth term. Okay, this is for finite GP. Afterwards we will see for infinite GP. So here finite terms are there. So GP we can write like this way: A, AR, AR square, and nth term is A R raised to n minus 1. Okay. So SN how we write? A plus AR plus AR square plus and so on, and last term is A R raised to n minus 1. Okay. This is equation 1. Now we have to multiply this equation by R. So if you multiply by R, we will get R into SN is equal to, this is AR, then AR square plus AR cube plus and so on, plus if you multiply by R here, R raised to 1, so minus 1 plus 1 will get cancelled, we will get AR raised to N. This is equation 2. Okay, here we have to multiply by R. Multiply equation 1 by R. Okay, then you have to subtract these two equations. SN minus R SN is equal to, now if you subtract this, here A remain as it is, this AR minus AR will get cancelled, AR square minus AR square will get cancelled and so on. Here AR raised to N minus 1 is there, so this term will get cancelled with this. So last remain A R raised to N. Okay. Now from this term we can take S N common. So what is remain? 1 minus R. From this we can take A common. So 1 minus R raised to N. Okay. So if you shift here, S N is equal to A into 1 minus R raised to N divided by 1 minus R. Okay. So this is the formula to find sum of the n terms of a GP. Okay, or we can use this formula also. SN is equal to A into if you take minus 1 common from both numerator and denominator, then we will get formula is A into R raised to n minus 1 upon R minus 1. Okay, mostly this formula we have to use when R is less than 1. Okay, R is common ratio. If it is less than 1, then we have to use this formula, and if R is greater than 1, we can use this formula. Okay, otherwise both formulae we can use. Okay, only we have to take minus and common and we will get answer. Okay, but mostly we are using this one. R less than 1, then 1 minus R raised to n upon 1 minus R into A, and if R greater than 1, R raised to n minus 1 upon R minus 1 into A. Okay, now by using this we have to derive another formula. If suppose we know that last term and first term, okay, so SN how we find this, we have to multiply this inside. So SN is equal to A minus A R raised to N upon 1 minus R. Okay, so A minus A R raised to N, I am writing like this way, A into R raised to N minus 1 into R. Okay, after simplifying we will get same term, A into R raised to N upon 1 minus R. So here A minus A into R raised to N minus 1 means last term, that is denoted as L into R divided by 1 minus R. So if we know that last term, we can use this formula. SN is equal to A minus LR upon 1 minus R, or we can use SN is equal to LR minus A upon R minus 1. Okay, understand this four formulas. Now we have to solve example based on this. One more point is that if suppose R is equal to 1, if R is equal to 1, then these formulas we cannot use. Okay, because if R is equal to 1, denominator becomes 0. Okay, so we cannot use this formula. So if R is 1 means terms are A plus A plus A and so on plus A n times. Okay, if r is 1. So we will get sum of the n terms of a GP is a plus a plus a plus a n times, that is Sn is equal to n into a. Okay, so if r is equal to 1, we cannot use this formula directly. Sum of the n terms of GP, we can write n into a. Okay, n into first term. Now we will solve example. First example is find the sum of 7 terms of GP, 3, 6, 12 and so on. Okay, so here a is equal to 3, r is equal to 6 by 3, that is a 2, and n is equal to 7. Now we have formula Sn is equal to, now here r is greater than 2, so we can use Sn is equal to a into r raised to n minus 1 upon r minus 1. Okay, so a, that is 3, r raised to n, so 2 raised to 7 minus 1 divided by 2 minus 1. Okay, so 3 into 2 raised to 7, that is 2 raised to 5 is 32, 32 2's are 64 into 2, that is 128 minus 1 upon 1. So 3 into, or here I am writing 3 into 128 minus 1, that is 127. So 3 7's are 21, 2, 3 2's are 6 plus 2, 8, 3 1's are 3. So answer is 381. Okay, so sum of 7 terms of GP, 3, 6, 12 and so on is 381. Okay, understand this one. Now we will take second example. The second question is find the sum of 10 terms of GP, 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8 and so on. Okay, so here a is equal to 1, r is equal to 1 by 2 divided by 1 means 1 by 2. Okay, now here r is less than 1, so I am using formula Sn is equal to a into 1 minus r raised to n divided by 1 minus r. Okay, so here a is 1, 1 minus r raised to n, here n is given 10, so s 10 is equal to 1, a is 1, so 1 into 1 minus r is 1 by 2 raised to 10 divided by 1 minus 1 by 2. Okay, so if you simplify this, 1, 1 minus 1 by 2 raised to 10, that is 1 upon 2 raised to 10 divided by 1 minus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. Okay, so again if you simplify this, 2 raised to 10 minus 1 upon 2 raised to 10 is equal, sorry, upon 1 by 2. Okay, this 1 by 2 becomes reciprocal, so 2 raised to 10 minus 1 upon 2 raised to 10 into 2 by 1. So if we cancel this one, so here we will get 2 raised to 10 minus 1 upon 2 raised to 9. So if we find 2 raised to 10, that is a 1024 minus 1 upon 2 raised to 9 is 2 raised to 5 is 32. Now if we divide it by 1024 by 2, that is I think 512. Okay, so if we simplify this, 1023 upon 512. Okay, so this is the sum of 10 terms. So S10 is equal to 1023 upon 512. Okay, now we will take third example. Third question is find the sum of the following series, 5 plus 55 plus 555 up to n terms. Okay, now 5, 55, 555, this is not GP, we have to convert in a GP. Okay, so Sn is equal to 5 plus 55 plus 555 up to n terms. Okay, so if we take 5 common, so what is remain? 1 plus 11 plus 111 plus and so on up to n terms. Okay. Now, if we divide it and multiply by 9, okay, so what we get? 5 by 9, and if we multiply by 9 inside, so 9 plus 99 plus 999 up to n terms. Okay, so 5 by 9, this 9 we can write 10 minus 1. This 99 we can write 10 square minus 1, that is 100 minus 1, plus this is 10 cube minus 1 up to n terms. So n here, first term that is 10 minus 1, second term 10 square minus 1, third term is 10 cube minus 1. So nth term we will get 10 raised to n minus 1. Okay. So if we simplify again, this 10 plus 10 square plus 10 cube plus and so on plus 10 raised to n. Okay, we have take this is together 10, 10 square, 10 cube and 10 raised to n. Then minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, that is n times. So minus 1 n times. Okay, so this is GP now 10, 10 square, 10 cube, 10 raised to n. Here r is 10. A is also 10. So if you simplify this, Sn is equal to 5 by 9. This RS, A into R is 12 minus 1. So A is 10. R is 12 minus 1. R is also 10. 10 is 12 minus 1 upon 10 minus 1. R minus 1. And this minus 1 n times. So we get minus n. Okay. So 5 by 9, if you multiply this 10 inside, so 10 into 10 raised to n, that is 10 raised to n plus 1 minus 10 upon this 9 minus n. Okay, so if you simplify again, 5 by 9, 10 raised to n plus 1 minus 10 minus 9n upon 9. Okay. Or you can write 5 upon 81, 10 raised to n plus 1 minus 10 minus 9n. Okay, this is the sum of n terms of GP. Okay, so if it is not GP, we have to convert in GP by using this way. Okay, method is same for each example. Okay, in of this type. Okay, so first we have to take common and multiply and divide it by 9, then convert in this form. And then convert in GP and use sum of n terms of GP. Okay, so we will get here sum is 5 by 81, 10 raised to n plus 1 minus 10 minus 9. Okay, now we will take next point, that is the sum of infinite terms of GP. So what is sum of an infinite GP? Okay, so if in GP infinite terms are there and if R is in between, means R is greater than minus 1 and less than 1. So it is in between minus 1 and 1, not minus 1 and 1. Okay, because if GP means if R is 1, so we cannot use that formulas. Directly we can use Sn is equal to n into a. So if R is in between minus 1 and 1, okay, then what is the sum of an infinite GP? So Sn is equal to, we know that formula, A into R raised to n minus 1 upon R minus 1. Okay. So we have this formula. Now if we simplify this, or we can write like this way, 1 minus R raised to n upon 1 minus R, because here R is less than 1. And if I simplify this, I am multiplying this A inside. So A minus A into R raised to n upon 1 minus R. Okay, I am separating the denominator 1 minus R for these two terms. So A divided by 1 minus R minus A into R raised to n divided by 1 minus R. Okay, now see here, if R is less than 1, okay, then R raised to n, if R is less than 1, divided by 1 minus r tends to 0. Okay, so this value becomes 0 if r raised to n tends to 0. This value becomes 0. So we will get Sn is equal to A upon 1 minus r. Okay, so if Sn is equal to A in A upon 1 minus if Gp is infinite and r is in between minus 1 and 1, then we will get Sn is equal to A divided by 1 minus r. Okay, I will explain this one again. If r is in between minus 1 and 1, okay, and Gp is infinite, then we will get Sn is equal to A divided by 1 minus r. How? So we have this formula, Sn is equal to A into 1 minus r s to n divided by 1 minus r. I am multiplying A to both terms, so we will get this A minus A r s to n upon 1 minus r. I am separating the denominator, so A divided by 1 minus r minus A r s to n divided by 1 minus r. Okay. Now if r is in between minus 1 and 1, and if n tends to infinity, okay, if we increase value of n, okay, then r s to n tends to infinity. R s to n tends to 0. Okay, suppose 1 by 2 is there. Okay, so 1 by 2 raised to 1, that is 1 by 2 means 0.5. okay, then 0.5 square, that is 0.25. 0.5 cube, that is 0.125. okay, so see here, these values are decreasing and this value tends to 0. Okay, so if r is in between minus 1 and 1 and n tends to infinity, then r s to n value tends to 0. So if r s to n value tends to 0 means this term tends to 0. Okay, so if this term tends to 0 means Sn is equal to only A divided by 1 minus r. Okay, so now we will solve example based on sum of an infinite g. Okay, first example is find the sum to infinity of the gp minus pi by 4, pi by 16, minus pi upon 64. Okay, so here we have to find the sum to infinity of the gp. Okay, so now s, that is equal to A divided by 1 minus r. We have to denote it as a s. Okay, because we have to find sum to infinity, so we cannot write sn. Okay, so I forgot to tell this. So here we have to write only s. S is equal to A divided by 1 minus r. Okay, we have to find sum to infinity of the gp. So s is equal to A divided by 1 minus r. Now here A is equal to minus pi by 4, r is equal to pi upon 16 upon minus pi by 4. So if we find this, pi by 16 into minus 4 by 5, so this will get cancelled. So r is equal to minus 1 by 4. Okay, so s is equal to A, that is a minus pi by 4 upon 1 minus r is equal to minus 1 by 4. So minus pi by 4 upon 1 plus 1 by 4, that is minus pi by 4 divided by pi by 4. So answer is minus 1. Okay, so sum of this gp up to infinity, that answer we will get minus 1. Okay, understand this one. Now we will take second example. Okay, second example is find the sum to infinity of the gp root 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus root 2 minus 1 up to infinity. Okay, so here A is equal to root 2 plus 1, r is equal to 1 divided by root 2 plus 1. Okay, so if we rationalize this, root 2 minus 1 multiply with root 2 minus 1, so we will get root 2 minus 1 upon root 2 plus 1 into root 2 minus 1, that is a root 2 square minus 1 square. So A plus B, A minus B, A square minus B square. So root 2 square minus 1 square. So So root 2 minus 1 upon root 2 square is 2 minus 1, that is a 1. So R, that is a root 2 minus 1, A is equal to root 2 plus 1. So S is equal to A divided by 1 minus R. A is root 2 plus 1 divided by 1 minus R is equal to root 2 minus 1. So root 2 plus 1 divided by 1 minus root 2 plus 1, that is a root 2 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 is 2. So 2 minus root 2. Okay. Now if you rationalize with 2 plus root 2. Okay. If you multiply this 2 into root 2, that is a 2 root 2. 2 into 1, 2. Root 2 into root 2, that is a 2. And root 2 into 1, that is a root 2. Divided by 2 minus root 2, 2 plus root 2, that is a 2 square minus root 2 square. Okay, a plus b, a minus b. Okay, now if you simplify this, 2 root 2 plus root 2, 3 root 2, and 2 plus 2, that is a 4, divided by 2 square is 4 minus root 2 square is 2. So 4 minus 2 is 2. Okay, further we cannot simplify. So 4 plus 3 root 2 upon 2, that is the value of S, that is sum of infinite terms of the G. This is G. Okay, understand this one. Now we will take properties of G. Next point is properties of geometric progression. Okay, so there are 6 properties. First we will discuss 3 properties. Okay, so here if all the terms, first one is if all the terms of a GP be multiplied or divided by the same non-zero constant, then resulting GP is the resulting sequence is a GP with same common ratio. Okay, and suppose if I am taking this GP 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on, and if I am multiplying by 3 to each number, so I will get here 6, 12, 24, 48 and so on. Okay, so 6, 12, 24, 48. Here if we find common ratio of these two GP, then that common ratio is the same. Okay, so if multiplied and if we divided by same non-zero constant to GP, to each term of GP, then resulting sequence is also GP with same common ratio. Okay, so this is first property. Second property is the reciprocals of the terms of a given GP form a GP. So if I am taking again same GP 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on. Okay, this is a GP. If I am taking terms, reciprocal terms of this GP, that is a 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 16 and so on. Okay, then we can see here this is also a GP. Okay, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 16. Okay, and if you find common ratio, that is 1 by 4 divided by 1 by 2. So we will get ratio is a 1 by 2. Okay, and here ratio is a 2. So if we take reciprocal terms, then that sequence is also GP. Okay, and common ratio, that is here if it is common ratio is R, here common ratio is a 1 by R. Okay, then third property is if each term of a GP raised to the same power, the resulting sequence also form GP. Okay, so if I am taking this GP 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on, and if I am raising each term by same power, so that is 2 square, 4 square, 8 square, 16 square and so on. Okay, then this sequence is also form of GP. Okay, you can check this one also. So this sequence also form of GP. So these are 3 properties. Okay, after that we will discuss another 3 properties. Fourth property is in a finite GP, the product of the terms equidistant from the beginning and the end is always same and it is equal to the product of first and last term. Okay, so in an AP, sum of the terms equidistant from beginning and end is always same and it is equal to the first and last term. Here it is a product. Okay, so if I am considering this is finite GPA 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. Okay, and only 5 terms I am considering. Okay, now here if I am taking second term from the beginning and second term from the end, so 4 and 16, product of these terms is 64. Okay, and if we take product of first and last term, that is also 64. Okay, so finite GP, in a finite GP the product of terms, if it is same from the beginning and end, it's same and it is equal to the product of first and last term. Okay, then fifth property is 3 non-zero numbers A, B, C are in GP if and only if B square is equal to AC. Okay, so if 3 non-zero numbers A, B, C, they are in GP, so if they are in GP, ratio between B and A and ratio between C and B, that is equal. Okay, so meaning of this means B square is equal to AC. Okay, so if 3 numbers are in GP, then square of the middle term is equal to product of first term and last term. Okay, in AP 2 times middle term is equal to sum of first term and last term. Okay, or first term and third term. But in GP square of the middle term is equal to product of first term and third term. Okay, so if 3 non-zero numbers are in GP, we will get B square is equal to AC, or if B square is equal to AC, then ABC are in GP. Okay, vice versa it is a true. Okay, then sixth property is if the terms of a given GP are chosen at regular intervals, then the new sequence so form also forms a GP. Okay, so again I am taking same example 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64 and so on. Okay, so if I am taking even place term, that is this one 4, 16, 64. Okay, so 4, 16, 64 also form a GP. Okay, so these are six properties. Another property is there, that is if A1, A2, A3, these terms are in GP, then log A1, log A2, log A3, these terms are in AP. Okay, and vice versa. Okay, but this will, that seven property you will understand after the lesson logarithm. Okay, so I am not taking here, but that is another property. If A1, A2, A3 is in GP, then log A1, log A2, log A3, these terms are in AP. Okay, and vice versa. So there are seven properties. Now we will take example based on these properties. So example is if P, Q, R are in AP. Okay, so P, Q, R are in AP given. Show that the P's, Q's and R's terms of a GP are in GP. Okay, so here I am taking, let A be the first term. Okay, I am taking here capital A because already small a is there in AP. Okay, so here I am taking let A be the first term and capital R be common ratio of GP. Okay, now what is the P term of GP? That is A into R raised to P minus 1 by using formula AN, that is A into R raised to N minus 1. Instead of here P is there, so P term is A into R raised to P minus 1. Q term is A into R raised to Q minus 1 and R term is A into R raised to R minus 1. Okay, now we have to show that these three terms are in GP. Okay, means we have to show that square of this term is equal to product of P's term and R's term. Okay, so to show a Q term square is equal to AP into AR. We have to show that these three terms are in GP. Pth term, Qth term and Rth term. That is, square of this middle term is equal to product of first term and third term. Okay. So here I am taking Qth term square, that is AQ square is Qth term is A into R raised to Q minus 1 and square of A. Okay. So if we take square, that is A square into R raised to Q minus 1 bracket square, that is 2Q minus 2. This 2 multiply to this Q minus 1. Okay. Now A square into R raise to 2Q, that is 2Q we can write P plus R, because P, Q, R are in AP, so 2Q we can write P plus R minus 2 as it is. Okay, since P, Q, R are in AP. Okay, so if P, Q, R are in AP, we know that 2Q is equal to P plus R. Okay, now A square into R is to P plus R minus 2. Okay, so I am writing A square into R is to P plus R minus 1. I am taking minus 2, I am writing like this, minus 1 minus 2. Okay, now I am separating this A square into R is to P minus 1 plus R minus 1. Okay, now I am writing this A into A square is here, so I am writing A into R raised to P minus 1 and A into R raised to R minus 1. We can separate this, okay, by using laws of exponent. A raised to M into A raised to N, A raised to M plus N. So A raised to M plus N, we can write A raised to M into A raised to N. So here R raised to P minus 1 plus R minus 1, we can write R raised to P minus 1 into R raised to R minus 1, and this A square we can write A into A. So I will get two terms, A into R raised to P minus 1 and A into R raised to R minus 1. So this means Pth term, that is AP, and this is R term, that is AR. Okay, so Qth term square is equal to product of Pth term and Rth term. Okay, so these three terms, Pth term, Qth term and Rth terms are in GP. Okay, understand this one. Now we will take one more example. 13 numbers are in GP. Okay, so now if we add 1 here, so we will get 6 minus D. If we add 4 here, we will get middle term is 9. And if we add 19 here, so 19 plus 5, that is 24 plus D are in GP. Okay, now these three numbers are in GP means, if ABC are in GP, then we have B square is equal to A into C. So if these three numbers are in GP, we have 9 square is equal to 6 minus D into 24 plus D. 81, then 6 into 24, 144 plus 6D minus 24D minus D square. So 144, 6D minus 24D minus 18D minus D square. This is the 81. So if you shift here, D square plus 18D, 81 minus plus 81 minus 144 is equal to 0. So D square plus 18D minus 63 is equal to 0. Okay, so if factorize this, 21 3 is up. So D square plus 21D minus 3D minus 63 is equal to 0. D, if we take common D plus 21 minus 3 common D plus 21. So D is equal to minus 21, or D is equal to 3. Okay, so here if we take D minus 21, terms are pi minus, we have to find the numbers. Okay, so 5 minus d, original numbers are a minus d, a plus d. So 5 minus d, so that is 5 minus minus 21, 5 plus 21, 26, then 5, and then 5 minus 21, that is minus 16. Okay, so 26, 5 minus 16, these are the numbers, okay, which are in AP. And if we add 1, 4 and 19 in this, we will get numbers which are in G. Okay, if I am taking D is 3, A is 5, so 5 minus minus 3, that is 5 minus minus 3, that is 8, then 5 and 5 plus 3, sorry, 5 minus 3, that is 2, 5 and 8. Okay, so if I am taking A is 5, D is minus 21, so numbers are this 26, 5 minus 16, and if A is equal to 5, D is equal to 3, numbers are 2, 5, 18. Okay.